I've been watching a lot of Kieslowski's early films, and he was a documentarian starting off for, you know, the first decade or decade and a half or 2 decades or whatever of his film career.
Jestem brzydką brunetką. Chciałbym nie chodzić do szkoły i mieć fajne dziecko.
And he never really had that much intention of going into feature films, but he started realizing that he didn't want to hurt people by, like, having them reveal their secrets, you know, on camera.
No, każdy człowiek ma do czegoś, wie pan, zamiłowanie. No ja mam, proszę pana, zamiłowanie do tej kontroli. Mam zamiłowanie kontrolować tych swoich kolegów, tych wędkarzy. Zabieramy kije, proszę pana, którzy nie mają opłacone karty czy siecie, proszę pana, zabieramy. No wie pan, ja można powiedzieć, mam takie hobby, do tego jestem, wie pan, przyzwyczajony po prostu.
And this was also, obviously, like, in a kind of like an emotional or psychological way, but also just in a very practical way, living in communist Poland.
Right.
You know?
Right.
He mentioned a situation. He filmed a piece called, I think it's just called Railway Station, and it's just like commuters in a railway station, you know, waiting for their train, looking tired, and, you know, stuff that's going on in the station. And after he did this film, it was confiscated for a while because it turned out that some woman who had, like, murdered a relative or something had gone and taken a train after committing a murder while he was filming.
Oh.
And so they were, like, trying to use his film as evidence to see if they could catch her on camera.
Oh, wow.
And so he talks about in his book, Kieslowski on Kieslowski. And I forget if they actually – they did catch her, but I think it was unsure whether his footage had helped or whether they actually found her on his footage or not. But the point was, he, even though, like, he's not against the idea of catching a murderer, he just, like, was uncomfortable with the idea that, like, his films would play a part
sure.
in any of that kind of thing, you know, like being an aide to the police or, like, any of this stuff. So he started moving into fictional work for that reason, because he felt like, I can have them say or do whatever I want them to say or do, and I don't have to worry about, you know,
right.
hurting them
yeah.
or having them expose what should remain private.
Right.
And it's interesting because obviously, like, it's not fiction is not entirely without this risk either when you're dealing with actors, right?
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, we could talk about, you know, this film.
There's
kind
of a nod to that. There's a scene with – so one of our main characters is a young lady in theater school, and there's a scene in her acting class where she's asked to get really intimate, really up close with another performer, but then also is kind of put into – kind of scandalous position with her instructor.
Powtarzając dobranoc, nie dałbym ci zasnąć. Widzisz, że umiesz patrzeć? Teraz dopiero jesteś skupiona.
And now, like, you can say maybe there's, like, already a relationship of trust between her and the instructor. Mm-hmm. We don't know that. Like, we're just seeing this one sort of snapshot into the class, but I think that it suggests to us this kind of danger, even for performers, of, like, going into these intimate or hidden places in performance.